Sindhi.
And I am Mansi Ajmera.
And we are from River Indrani. And our topic is rise of HMM-AB in Indian markets.
The content which we are going to cover today are introduction,
brands under HMM,
categories,
segment, target and positioning,
rise of HMM,
reasons for growth,
competitors
and conclusion.
Introduction. H&M, that is Hans & Moritz AB, is a Swedish multinational company which covers the categories of men, women, children and teenagers. It was established in 1947 and earlier it used to sell only women clothing under the name Hans, but later on it merged with a retailer named Moritz Whitfors and started including men's clothing under it. Its current CEO is Carl John Pearson. The motto is to bring fashion and quality at best price. It's the second largest global clothing retailer and at present the number of stores in India are 42.
Brands under H&M. It covers Monkey, Weekday, Cheap Monday and other stories, arcade, collection of styles, H&M Homes, A-Found, Monkey. Monkey includes the clothing for teenage girls and college students and it is cheaper than the other brands under H&M. Next is Weekday. Earlier, when the Weekday was opened, it was opened for Sunday and Saturday only. But due to its increased sale, it is open on weekdays as well. All weeks as well. Next is Cheap Monday. Cheap Monday is especially for the denim jeans for man, woman and kids. Next, Arknet. Arknet focuses on home wares and accessories, shoes, clothing and other stories focuses on shoes, accessories and shoes, accessories and bags as well. And collection of style. Collection of style focuses on trendy, less trendy clothes with classical clothes for women and men. Next, H&M Homes. H&M Homes contains home wares with stylish home wares and other is A-Found. A-Found also contains clothing which is the latest among all the brands under H&M.
So, the categories offered by H&M are clothing, cosmetic and accessories, footwear, home accessories and decoration. Clothing is covered by almost all the brands of H&M, whereas cosmetic and accessories are covered by and other stories. Footwear is also covered by and other stories. And home accessories and decoration is covered by H&M Homes.
H&M segmentation, target and positioning. The motive of H&M is that everyone can get their clothes of their style in their shop. And its segmentation is focused on trendy and fashionable people who want to look fashionable at affordable prices. Now the target group, it focuses on women, men, kids, toddlers and also positioning. H&M has made the position, although it is a premium brand in India, but as compared to other premium brands in India, it is cheaper.
Rise of H&M in Indian market. H&M entered in India in 2015 with its first store in New Delhi and today it covers 42 stores across the country. H&M crossed 1,100 crore sales in the 3 years after entering the Indian market. H&M grew its sales to 95.5% for the year 2017 to rupees 956.24 crore, which nearly doubles its sales growth from the year 2016. In 2018, H&M started its online business in India and in 2019, it's planning to enter into a partnership with Myntra and Jabong to sell its clothing online. This year, H&M sales jumped to 39% at the end of quarter two, that is at the end of May. Now, reasons for growth. Expansion in the number of stores across the country. As we saw that by the end of 2017, H&M almost doubled its sales and this is one of the main reasons, that is the expansion of stores across the country. Next is target group includes women, men, teenagers and kids. As it covers almost most of the section of the society and thus this adds to another reason for the growth of H&M in India. Next is started online business in India. It started online business in India and which adds to another reason for the rise of H&M in Indian market. And before moving into new country, an assessment is made of the market. And next is low price as compared to its competitors. It has low price as compared to its competitors like Zara and offers the same quality of products.
Competitors. Competitors include Zara, Gap and Forever 21. Among all, Zara is the main competitor of H&M. And this net sales includes 1408 crores, 1221 crores of Zara, Gap 19.8 lakh crores and Forever 21 99 crores. Although Zara and H&M are the main competitors and the H&M is most going to be successful by 2022 by opening the more stores and it offers us clothing in less price and the quality is same.
Conclusion.
H&M has a stable growth in Indian market. As by 30th November 2018, it has 39 stores in India. But now it has plus 12, that is 42 stores in India. And by 2020, it is planning to open more than 50 stores in India. It has attracted customers due to its store expansion and online business. As we all know that H&M has expanded its business in Myntra and Jabon.com, due to which its sales has recently increased as well.
Within 3 years of its entry, it has covered a good section of the market. H&M came up as a good competitor for other clothing brands in India like Zara, Forever 21 and others.
And H&M is also looking forward to take over Zara by 2020, thank you.
Bibliography.